That's my Nomi. Although I guess it's gnome. If the word is home, then that should be gnome. Which is probably named that because the creatures he lives with are gnomes. See? It's all coming together. Try and get around to the other side there. Which you can't do. Might as well hang out here and kill these guys. I like to try and kill as many of the monster lair enemies as possible out of range and as early as I can. It'll just make for an easier time when I There we go. See, now, you know, I don't have to worry about those enemies respawning or anything. I just come back to them. Yeah, those things, they can turn into kind of a pain. And now you can get across. See? Nice and easy. Even got a little XP out of the whole thing. I love that it has those gems that they can offer you the chance to go back. If I remember right, in this area I got a little bit lost. I think there were extra monster lairs and I was looking to destroy them. Funny, I want to switch to live commentary. I just like live commentary better. I think it's funnier and more reactionary. But at the same time, I also don't want to get into the situation, the habit of, you know, recording and uploading a bunch of videos where I'm getting lost half the time and I'm looking around and I have no idea, because that's it can be fun. It's, you know, especially if you've got a few people there, you know, a few commentators and they're bouncing stuff off each other and making jokes and everything. But as a solo person, as it being just me, I can't imagine that it's too interesting just sitting there listening to me be annoyed because I'm lost. Yeah, see, this is the kind of stuff that starts to overwhelm you. Which, yeah, a lot of that was carelessness. I'll definitely give it that. Just the way I play some of these games. Yes, if you don't want to use magic or if you run out of magic, that's basically what you're supposed to do. Wait until just the right moment and then you should be able to swing on them. But really, I think this is sort of what the magic in the game is for. You know, most enemies you can hack and slash them. So I like to save the magic for things that, you know, have special movement patterns and stuff like that. It makes it a lot easier. Oh yeah, we got him a grandma. See, now there's a monster lair there. There we go. That was a good one. Back to the temple, so you know what that means. Take care of that guy really quick. It's a little weird with the tight corners because they won't, sometimes they won't appear. So if they're, if for whatever reason that you're playing and they're not appearing, just move around a little bit. Swing. Another grandma, that guy is. Guys, he's got himself a good position there. Yeah, so you see one monster lair remaining. This is me saving because, let's face it, the boss is coming, and I think it was the last boss we didn't do too well. One monster lair left, which I think I just figure is the one from the boss. Okay, so this boss here has kind of a simple pattern. It's gonna shoot that, it's gonna stab, and then shoot those fires. You can kind of cheese this fight by doing exactly what I'm doing here. Take that hit. You know, have the shield bracelet on. You only get a few moments to attack. Like the other bosses, it's basically metal, so you can't hit it with magic. You know, but for some reason, the fireballs glitch through you. You know, that doesn't hit you, and then the fire doesn't hit you. So as long as you just stand right there, this is just very patient. You know, a lot of just take that first hit. Keep the shield bracelet on, because if you don't have the shield bracelet on, the first hit that you take, they'll actually do enough damage to kill you even after you burn your medical herb. If you go in there with full health, take that hit, use your medical herb, and keep going. You'll die before the boss does. I know I can't hit it with magic, I was just having fun there. There we go. So now we got it to a point where its health is showing. And it's just going to start winding down. When it gets to a certain point, if you're comfortable with your health, if your level is high enough, and you don't mind using your medical herb, you can switch over to the power bracelet. Do a little bit extra damage. I think I still have the lucky sword on. You can switch to the critical sword. I think it does a little bit of extra damage sometimes. But the basic hits won't do as much because the lucky sword is a little bit stronger. So it's better just to keep the lucky sword on. See, now I'll switch to the power bracelet because even with the hits that I'm taking, I won't die before the boss does. I tried something here. I tried to take the hit with the shield bracelet and then switch to the power bracelet really quick. Which works, I just didn't swing fast enough, so I got less hits in. I think at this point I don't remember if I switch back to the shield bracelet or if I think I just stay with the power bracelet. Yeah, if you saw there, I took some high damage with that one. So that shield bracelet is actually very, very useful. You know, it's not defeated by special boss attacks that will always take the same amount of damage or anything like that. That's what you see in a lot of games where you have a special armor that reduces everything by half, but then when you fight bosses, it only reduces them by 25% or something like that. This game, it was straight up half as half. There we go, not too tough. The king is free! Or saved, or restored, or... So yeah, monster lair remaining zero. But then there is still one in here. So I think this is where I went to try to search for it, so... This might be the moment where you get up and get something to drink. Kill all of those because I figured maybe it was tied to that, and there it is, but there's no way to get to it, which usually means you get to it in a dream sequence or you're gonna get to it later with an item that you don't have. At this point I'm trying to just get a better look at it. But nothing. That's why. We'll come back later. Wrong one. There we go. Let's go talk to the king, see what he has to say for himself. See? I saved you. You didn't come back. Like the mermaid queen. Oh, our queen came back. No, I saved her. Ooh, the phoenix. Look, three more things to collect. Like, that stuff was just... It's just randomly there. You know, I got those 8 emblems to try and collect. Now these 3 more items... In addition to the stuff that you actually have to collect for the game, you know, the different colored stones. Now, I'm supposed to talk to the imprisoned snail. A sentence I never thought I'd say. So, of course, you talk to everybody else first. Ah. A laboratory of metal monsters. Yeah, see, there we go. Which is that's a funny warning, because that's the only way to get out of that dream sequence is to walk away from it. So he gave 4 of the stones away, And then there's a stone in Dr. Leo's lab, and one in the castle of Magrid. Hey, I got the silver stone. That's perfect. Alicia will be pleased. Or Alicia, I'm sorry. She's gonna get mad if she finds out I pronounced it wrong. Get back to where we hit that switch and opened up that the last passageway. That was the final monster lair. But for the life of me, I don't remember where it was. Which I think it was right there. I probably could have saved all of this and done this during backtracking. I don't like to backtrack too much in small bits. I like to wait towards the end of the game when I've got a whole bunch of stuff and then just go back to the beginning and then backtrack all the way up. Yep, so that was the last monster lair. So let's head back, take the portal back to the town. Okay, wrong one again. Okay, now to try and remember where that was that I opened. Nope, not there. No one wants to watch your snail race. Was it down here? No. 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 Can't for the life of me remember where that was. Even now, as I'm sitting here doing this commentary, I don't remember if I even found it. There's a good chance at this point I gave up and I just left. Yep, gave up. Pretty sure I'll just come back to it later. But that's it. That area has been saved, so we're gonna move on. And I will see you guys here in Dr. Leo's laboratory, full of metal monsters.